Welcome to IGSS Online Training. I'm Per Frederiksen from Seven Technologies Denmark, and I'm here to present our SCADA system, IGSS. This is lesson 22, Safe Commands and Audit Trail. These two features have been added to IGSS version 8, and we'll now go through each of these features in detail. We'll start with safe commands. I will tell you what is a safe command, and we will go in and we will look at the users in user administration, because safe commands rely on user administration being enabled. We will look at how safe commands work in the supervised module for the operator, and then finally we'll go in and we'll design them, design the safe commands in the definition module. We have three different safe commands. We can look into our demo configuration. We are now in the supervised module. And if you go to the first page of our demo configuration, you have the button News in version 8. When you go in there, you can click on Save Commands to see this picture. We have, first of all, Confirm, which is a simple confirmation dialog box that comes up so that the operator must press OK to carry out a command. Then we have Confirm by Password, where the user must enter a username and password. And finally, Confirm by Two Users, where one user carries out the command and the next user must approve the operation. Of course, the two latter require that user administration is enabled, and that's why we also go into the user administration module. Let's start up the user administration module to see which users we have defined for this demo configuration. Double click on the user administration icon and enter the username admin, small letters, and again admin, again with small letters, as the password. We click OK and we're inside the user administration module. Now let's take a look at the users we have defined for the demo. File user groups. We have defined two groups, admin and user. We can see that the admin user is allowed to do everything here. He has all the global rights. The user has a restricted number of rights in our system. Let's go file users and passwords. And again, we can see that the admin user, of course, is a member of the admin user group, and the user is a member of the user group. So those are the two users we have in our demo configuration. We can use them for safe commands. Let's try it out. Let's go back to the safe commands picture and let's try the confirm option first. The user simply clicks on this valve, the close button here, and a dialog comes up saying, you're about to send a command to this object. Do you want to continue? And he presses OK, and the command is carried out. Let's take the most advanced option, confirm by two users. As you remember, we have two users in this example, user and admin, so we'll use those two users when we click the open command. You're about to send a command. Who's carrying out this command? User. He presses OK, and then the other user, admin, must verify or approve this operation, and we click OK. Now, how do we set this up in definition? Let's switch to the definition module. Definition module, we go into the view called Save Commands. And if we double click on this object that we just manipulated in Supervise, then we can see on the Data Management Definitions tab that we have a new option called Save Commands. We simply drop down this box and we can see confirm, confirm password, confirm to users. It's as simple as that. Of course, you should use the property table view. Right click the diagram, property table view, click objects, and then you can see all the objects and you can turn on and off these save commands in the property table view like this. Very, very easy. Confirm password, for example, press OK, and we have three objects protected by this save command. An expansion of the security in IGSS and tracking is the new Audit Trail program. If you remember, we saw it in the start menu. Here it is. You can start it from here. You can also auto-start Audit Trail together with IGSS. So when the user clicks the start button, it automatically starts up. Now, how do you set up the Audit Trail before you begin? You must go into the System Configuration module. And in the System Configuration module, you should go to the Files tab. And on the Files tab, you'll find a new section called Audit Trail. Audit Trail, and it says SQL Active. So it saves all its data in an SQL database. But of course, this SQL database must be set up first. SQL Settings. This is my current setup. As you can see, I have data source. That's my computer name, / SQL Express. Initial catalog is Audit Trail. And this is very easy to set up because we have included an SQL database file. If you click on the question mark here in this dialog box, click on the button, go to configuring an IGSS SQL server, creating the Audit Trail database in SQL, then it takes you through all the steps in setting up Audit Trail. That's it for setting it up. And on the access control tab, we have two different things we need to do. We must make sure that this checkbox disable access control is not selected because we want user administration to be active. And then under Audit Trail, we will say keep a record of all user activity. And we will make sure that all these checkboxes are enabled so that all output, limits, acknowledgement, etc. is stored in the Audit Trail. That's it. We can close down system configuration. And we can start up the Audit Trail manually like this. Double click it. Here it is. And what you can see is that all the actions that I'm doing right now in my demo, they are recorded here. Right now I'm looking at today. That's my period, right? I can change that. I can say what happened yesterday. There are also a few options here. System started and stopped. Let's switch back to today. Look at the first line here. This is an output command. It was done on the demo station, and the user carried out the command, and the admin user approved the command. So this was a safe command that we did there. Very, very handy for secure processes like the medical industry and production processes. What else can we do in IGSS Audit Trail? Well, we can go in and we can make a filter. So let's make a filter for the admin user. Let's take username admin, and we can see that nothing is recorded right now. So that's because we haven't logged into our system. So let's go back to supervise and then log into the system. Login, that's the admin user, admin. Okay, now the admin user is logged into our system. Let's go back to Audit Trail, and we can see that he's currently logged in. So basically, if I go back and I do a couple of actions now, like manual close, manual open, and I can acknowledge an alarm also, like this. And when we go back to Audit Trail, all this has been recorded. So that was the admin user, and we can switch on the output type. We want to see all output that he has created. This is a filter, and now we want to save it as a view. Save as view, admin user, output. Click OK, and that view is in our system, and we can just click over here and activate it like this. Good. The Audit Trail is also a possibility. It also has a possibility of adding an Audit Trail widget to the dashboard, which is presented in one of the other videos. So we'll come back to that at that moment. Finally, in Audit Trail, you can add a note. When you're logged into the system, the Add Note icon is visible and active. You click here and you say, "This is an Audit Trail note." This is also a new feature because you used to have object notes in IGSS, but now you can also just put in a general configuration note, as I've just done here. Click OK, and that's it. the audit trail will record all user actions. Thank you for listening. For further information about audit trail, please refer to the help file, and also you can go to our website for further details.